It's Professor Dave. Let's graph inequalities.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We've learned a lot about graphing functions, and graphing inequalities will be extremely similar, but there are a few additional points to discuss, so let's go through those now. First, let's recall what an inequality is. Rather than an equation, where the two sides are equivalent to one another, inequalities state that one side is greater than the other, or less than the other, or sometimes greater than or equal to, or less than or equal to. So if x is greater than or equal to 3, then x could be 3, or any real number greater than 3, including 3.001, pi, 7 halves, or a billion. The first thing we need to do is learn how to solve inequalities that are a little more involved than the simple ones we've seen before. Take something like x squared plus 6x is less than negative 5. To solve this, we get everything on one side so that the function is either greater than 0 or less than 0. In this case, we add 5 and we get this. Then, we pretend that the less than sign is an equals sign, and we solve the equation. In this case, that would require factoring this to get x plus 1 times x plus 5, which gives us negative 1 and negative 5 as the solutions. Then we can draw a number line and mark these points. Then, to see which sections of the number line satisfy the inequality, we just pick a point from each section and see if it works. In between, we could try negative 2. Negative 2 squared is 4, plus negative 12 is negative 8, plus 5 is negative 3. Negative 3 is less than 0, so this section is a solution to the inequality. Now let's move over to the right. 0 is always an easy one to try, so let's use that. 0 plus 0 plus 5 is 5, which is not less than 0, so from negative 1 to positive infinity, these values don't work. Trying the other side, let's use negative 6. 36 plus negative 36 gives us 0, plus 5 is 5, so none of these values work. The solution to the inequality is everything from negative 5 to negative 1 exclusive, which we denote by writing this parenthetical term. This approach will work for trickier inequalities with many terms on both sides. We just combine all the like terms on one side so that the other side is 0, and then solve. Whatever the zeros are, we then just test points to find out which intervals make the cut. When polynomial inequalities contain two variables, like y is greater than or equal to x plus 2, these become interesting to graph. When we do this, the first step is to treat this inequality as though it were an equation, so y equals x plus 2. As we should know at this point, this will just be the line y equals x, but shifted up 2, given this vertical shift term here. Now, what the inequality says is that y must be greater than or equal to this. So for any input x, y must be greater by 2 or more. So when x is 0, y must be 2 or more. When x is 1, y must be 3 or more. That means that every point on this line is a solution to the inequality, as is every point in the xy plane that is above this line, since every point above the line has a y value that is greater than the corresponding y value of the line. We would denote this by shading in this section of the coordinate plane, implying that everything above this line is a solution to the inequality. We can do the same thing for y is greater than x squared minus 4. We just graph the function and shade in everything above it, or the section containing points with y values that are greater than the y value for the point on the function directly below. Now let's look at rational inequalities. As we could probably guess after learning how to graph rational functions, these are just inequalities where one side is a rational function. Take something like 2x plus 2 over x plus 3 is greater than 0. We can solve this by figuring out a few things about it. First, the x-intercept. We get that by setting the function equal to 0. We can then multiply both sides by the denominator, which makes it vanish, because when multiplied by 0, it becomes 0. Subtract 2, divide by 2, and negative 1 must be the x-intercept. Then we can find the vertical asymptote by setting the denominator equal to 0. X equals negative 3 must be the asymptote. Then we can graph the function by testing points near the asymptote, intercept, and approaching either infinity. Once we arrive at a sketch of the function, we go back to the inequality. This asks when the function is greater than 0. So the question is, in what intervals is the function above the line y equals 0? That would be from negative infinity up until negative 3, then from negative 3 to negative 1, the function is negative, and then beyond negative 1, the function is positive again. So we get negative infinity to negative 3 and negative 1 to positive infinity, both exclusive. So we use parentheses and we put a U for union in between, meaning these two intervals together comprise the solution of the inequality. We will learn more about this kind of notation when we go over set theory a little bit later. That's pretty much all there is to solving and graphing polynomial and rational inequalities, so let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.